You know what's interesting to recognize is that scripturally, at the end of every age, prophetic voices come, and they will bring a message of judgment.
Hmm.
Not because not for dramatic effect, but because with the end of every age, decisions have to be made.
Hmm.
And so God sends prophetic voices at the end of every at the close of every age to bring a warning. And I've said before that you know, prophetic utterances from God are always sharp but never harsh.
Hmm.
They are sharp because they're to the point.
True.
They are accurate, they are descriptive, they are predictive, but they're never harsh because God always offers a way out. So it doesn't surprise me at all that at the end of this age, prophetic voices are raised up through books and through the PVL network and different things,
mm-hmm.
where prophetic voices can come and bring a sharp, accurate close of the age message. Wow. And this was something that the Lord has spoke to me
about.
You
were there that night.
Right.
Why do you think you were there?
I'll tell you, in the natural, I was there because everyone else was going, and this was the part of the church I was involved in, and there I was. In the natural, that's why mm-hmm. I thought I was
yeah.
there. But while I was there, when you got up to speak, and we were saying in the first show yesterday, there was a look of pained conviction on you.
Hmm.
It almost...
It was, it says this in this book now. See, I haven't read the book in years, but it said... My notes were in my briefcase,
mm-hmm.
and I wasn't sure if I was going to preach.
Well,
I
was going to say, it almost looked like you were hesitant in the presentation of this message.
Mm-hmm. It's amazing how you can remember it so many years ago.
Well, here's why I remember it. I remember it because, like I told you all in the green room, as Pastor James started preaching this and delivering this message, mm-hmm. it looked like we were all on the edge of our seats just holding on.
Mm.
Because this was not what, or at least me, I can only speak for me, this was not what I expected to hear from Jim Bakker. It just wasn't,
mm-hmm.
you know. And it made me think so many ways.
Hmm.
For one thing, I didn't know what to think, to be honest with you.
I'm sure you didn't.
Hmm.
How confusing this must
when
be for someone
you,
from
when
Singapore.
When did you know
wow.
that what I had spoken was met for the future of Singapore?
Well, like we said, I think within 18 months, really the whole of Asia went through an economic turmoil and a flip, you know. And sure enough, the people at church were saying, remember that meeting back, it was called the Indoor Stadium.
Yes.
Yeah.
Right? And people talked about that, and I thought, well, I guess here we are, you know. But isn't it, I think that people misunderstand prophecy because they think they understand the judgment part of it, but they don't understand that with the judgment, the delivery of the potential judgment, there actually always is grace and mercy.
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
Amen.
Like when you look at, you know, the cross of Jesus Christ is where you see the perfect marriage of the judgment and the love of God melted into one.
Yeah.
Because on the cross, you see the judgment of God, the wrath of God poured out, but you also see the love and the mercy of God at the same time.
Amen. Mm.
And that's a perfect picture of a prophetic utterance.
Yes.
There is always judgment in it, but there's always grace and mercy come. And that's how I would see this book, Mondo. That's how I would see this message. That's how I would see what the PTL network is about.
Mm.
It is about grace and mercy.